The number 7 at LSU has produced quite a few All-Americans, like Patrick Peterson, Leonard Fournette, and Tyrann Mathieu. So when you wear that jersey, you know that big responsibilities come with it. Enter Jonathan Giles. The Texas Tech transfer has shown flashes of his abilities in the Big 12, but now it's his time to prove it in the SEC.
First and foremost, bigger, faster, and stronger. A lot of guys that were 6'6", running 4.2s, 4.3s on that field. And then also the fan base, it was amazing.
That was Giles' first impression of LSU as the Tigers met up with his Red Raiders in the 2015 Texas Bowl when he was a true freshman. Unknown at the time, that would influence his decision to move to Baton Rouge a year later.
LSU is known for having a great team, you know, great history, great tradition, great fan base. So when Coach O called me, I told him right then, I just want to be a part of a great team and a great unit of guys.
And it's safe to say the love was mutual from the Tigers. Giles was a breakout star for Texas Tech in 2016. He led the team with 69 catches and his over 1,100 yards and 13 touchdowns ranked in the top 25 in the nation. Head coach Ed Orgeron wasn't going to let this big fish get away.
When he first called me, before I even said hello, the first thing he said when I answered the phone was, we love your film. Also, I really came here too because he called me at 6:30 in the morning on a Tuesday. So that lets you know how much he meant, how much I meant to him in the program.
After sitting out a year, Giles is now preparing for his primetime role under wide receiver guru Jerry Sullivan.
And I'm pushing up the field, accelerating up the field.
The new LSU passing game coordinator spent 25 years in the NFL helping pro bowlers like Larry Fitzgerald and Anquan Boldin, among others.
He's preaching technique and fundamentals, footwork. I mean, he preaches that every day. He'll call us before we go to bed. It takes us at night. Think about your technique and footwork. You know, study the film. It's on our iPad. So, and he not only does a good job of teaching us about techniques and fundamentals. He also shows video of him coaching the NFL from his past with NFL receivers. So you get to see like we're doing the exact same thing he did when he was in the NFL.
While he has yet to play a game in Tiger Stadium, Giles has already made an impression on his LSU teammates. In the receiver room, he's a leader. And on the practice field, he's a force.
Anything that came his way was getting caught. I mean, people would say his wingspan or his radius wasn't, but I mean, once he's running a route, he might as well be 6'11 running a route with a 10-foot wingspan.
The thing that Giles is most excited about this season is that he won't have to do it alone, as the Tigers have up to 7 receivers that he listed that could contribute this year, including true freshman Jamar Chase out of Rummel, who he says that if he continues to perform like he's done in fall camp so far, he will see playing time on Saturday nights.